Welcome to PC Analytics. Today, we're going to dig into the differences between the Noctua NH-D15 versus budget cooler, the Peerless Assassin 120SE. We've got our test bench right here, ready to put these coolers to the test and give you all the information you need to make the perfect choice for your setup. Let's start with the Noctua NH-D15, which is a dual tower cooler with 6 heat pipes and 2 Noctua fans. The NH-D15 is a beast of a cooler that offers excellent cooling performance and low noise levels. The dual tower design ensures that there's plenty of surface area for heat dissipation, while the 6 heat pipes transfer heat away from the CPU quickly and efficiently. But don't underestimate the smaller size of the Peerless Assassin 120SE. Despite having smaller radiators and fans, it still packs a punch with its dual tower 6 heat pipe setup. Given its size, it's great for setups that are looking for a more compact air cooler that doesn't break the bank. However, we know you're here to see how the Peerless Assassin stacks up against the NH-D15, so let's get into it. We've tested both coolers over idle, high, and overclock temperatures, and have 2 sets of charts to show you. One that looks at performance normalized by percent speeds, and one that looks at performance normalized by sound. In our first set of charts normalized by percent speeds, we have temperatures on the left represented by the solid lines, noise on the right represented by the dashed lines, and percent speeds on the bottom. For this graph, lower is always better. When the CPU is at idle, both coolers perform similarly across all percent speeds. But when we push the CPU to 105 watts, we can see that the NH-D15 offers a little better cooling across the board, while the Peerless Assassin is a bit louder at the higher RPMs. Even at overclock levels of 125 watts, the Peerless Assassin only runs a few degrees hotter than the NH-D15, which is still great performance. In our second set of charts normalized by noise levels, the trend continues at idle. However, as we increase the wattage to 105, the NH-D15 cooler pulls ahead and provides better cooling at every noise level. And even when we push the CPU to overclock levels of 125 watts, the NH-D15 widened its lead. And if you're curious about other budget coolers, you should check out this video comparing the NH-D15 to the AK620. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this content, hit that like and subscribe button. It really means a lot.